Uranus and Neptune are the most distant planets in the solar system. Both share similar characteristics that are classified with their category, icy giants, because both have shallow temperatures. However, even though Neptune is the farthest planet, Uranus is the coldest. Why is this happening? Let's find out. In the solar system, we have observed that planets closest to the sun are usually hotter and the farthest ones colder. However, this rule is not always followed, since Venus is the hottest planet, even though Mercury is the closest. In the case of Uranus, something similar happens since it's colder than Neptune, although the latter is a billion kilometers farther away. While Neptune, the most distant planet in our solar system, is 4.5 billion kilometers from the sun, Uranus, the second farthest planet, is only 2.88 billion kilometers away and is colder. The atmosphere is more important than the distance. While the distance to the sun is a critical factor that determines the temperatures of the planets, probably the atmosphere is even more so. For example, in the case of Venus, it is much hotter than Mercury because its dense atmosphere traps heat and does not let it out, which causes a lasting greenhouse effect that keeps the surface of the planet consistently above 480 degrees Celsius. In the case of Uranus, the atmosphere also plays a crucial role in understanding why it is colder than Neptune. Uranus has the coldest planetary atmosphere in the solar system, with a minimum temperature of 49 Kelvin or minus 224 degrees Celsius. It also has a very complex cloud structure, arranged by levels, where it is believed that the lowest clouds are composed of water and the highest of methane. Although there is no well-defined solid surface inside Uranus, the outermost part of Uranus's gaseous envelope, accessible by remote sensing, is called the atmosphere. The composition of this atmosphere is different from that of the rest of the planet, as it consists mainly of molecular hydrogen and helium. Also, the internal heat of Uranus appears to be lower than that of the other giant planets. In astronomical terms, it has a low thermal flux. It is not yet clear why Uranus's internal temperature is so low. One of the hypotheses for this discrepancy is that when Uranus received the impact that caused its high axial tilt, the event caused it to expel most of its primordial heat, depleting its core temperature. Another hypothesis is that there is some barrier in the upper layers of Uranus that prevents heat from the core from reaching the surface. For example, there may be convection in a set of layers of different compositions, which inhibits the transport of heat upwards, causing Uranus to lose heat very slowly compared to the rest of the planets. Uranus's atmosphere is remarkably smooth compared to the other gas giants at ultraviolet and visible wavelengths, especially if we compare it to its twin Neptune. When Voyager 2 flew by Uranus in 1986, it observed 10 cloud forms on the entire planet. One proposed explanation for why there are so few is that the low temperature of Uranus prevents too many mixtures of gases at different temperatures, as happens in Jupiter or Saturn, where the temperature differences between the cloud layers are substantial, and that produces hurricanes and eddies that can last for centuries. While on Uranus, there are not many temperature variations. In fact, the lowest temperature recorded in the tropopause of Uranus is 49 Kelvin, making Uranus the coldest planet in the solar system, and at the same time, and the calmest in atmospheric terms of all the gas giants. In 1986, Voyager 2 discovered that the visible southern hemisphere of Uranus could be subdivided into two regions, a bright polar cap and dark equatorial bands. However, in the 90s, the number of observed bright cloud forms grew considerably, partially thanks to the availability of new high-resolution image processing techniques. It was observed that most appeared in the northern hemisphere, which is thought to be due to their tilt. For its part, Neptune, orbiting so far from the sun, receives very little heat. Its surface temperature is minus 218 degrees Celsius, or 55 Kelvin. However, the planet appears to have an internal source of heat. It is thought that it may be a remnant of the heat produced by the concentration of matter during its creation, which now radiates heat slowly into space. This internal heat source produces robust climate systems around the planet, such as the Great Dark Spot that the Voyager 2 probe discovered as it passed through the Neptune system in 1989. Another theory suggests that in the depths of Neptune, there are tidal conditions for carbon atoms to combine into crystals, releasing heat in the process. Therefore, this hypothesis raises the possibility that in Neptune, it rains diamonds. Neptune's color differs from that of Uranus because of the amount of helium in its atmosphere, which is slightly greater. Because of this, Neptune absorbs more red light from the sun than its neighboring planet, reflecting a much more intense blue. Neptune's atmosphere has a band structure similar to the other gas giants. Phenomena such as giant hurricanes with a diameter equal to that of the Earth and other cloud formations, including some extensive cirrus clouds above 50 kilometers, the main clouds, occur on this planet. Thus, Neptune has a very active cloud system, possibly more active than Jupiter's. Also, the wind speed in Neptune's atmosphere is up to 2,000 kilometers per hour, the highest in the solar system, and is believed to be fed by internal heat flow. Neptune's atmosphere is 80% hydrogen and 19% helium at high altitudes. A small amount of methane is also present. This causes prominent methane absorption bands at wavelengths above 600 nanometers in the red and infrared portion of the spectrum. Neptune's meteorology is characterized by very dynamic storm systems, with winds reaching almost 600 meters per second or 2200 kilometers per hour, and almost reaching supersonic flow speeds. More typically, by tracking the movement of persistent clouds, wind speeds have been shown to vary from 20 meters per second in the easterly direction to 325 meters per second to the west, a gigantic difference that produces hurricanes more intense than those of Jupiter. At the top of the clouds, the prevailing wind speed ranges from 400 meters per second along the equator to 250 meters per second at the poles. But in general, most Neptune winds move in a direction opposite to the planet's rotation, which is similar to what happens on Venus. Neptune is a much more active planet than Uranus, as it has an internal heat source that causes more storms, winds, and a constant exchange of temperatures between internal and external clouds. In contrast, Uranus has a much calmer atmosphere, without as many temperature exchanges, so it does not have as many storm clouds or hurricanes as the rest of the gaseous planets. The tilt of both planets. If Uranus is known for something, it is for being the only planet in the solar system that is almost totally inclined to the sun at an angle of 97 degrees. This produces changes in the seasons in a completely different way than the other major planets. The rotation of other planets can be visualized as spinning tops, inclined concerning the solar system plane, while Uranus rotates like a ball, rolling inclined. When the solstices of Uranus approach, one pole continuously faces the sun, while the other is in the opposite direction. Only a narrow band around the equator experiences a rapid day and night cycle, with the sun very low above the horizon, as in the Earth's polar regions. On the other side of Uranus's orbit, the pole's orientation in the sun's direction is reversed. Each pole receives about 42 years of uninterrupted sunlight, followed by 42 years of darkness, a world where you would have to wait 42 years to see the sunlight again. This inclination causes the side of the planet where it is night not to reach a single ray of sunlight for a long time. And because of this, the planet's temperatures drop considerably. In contrast, Neptune has an inclination angle of only 28 degrees, which gives it a more excellent stability in its annual seasons, because like Earth, the only areas where it receives less heat are at the poles. Still, the rest of the planet is always illuminated by the sun. In conclusion, we can determine that the reason why Uranus is colder than Neptune is 1. For its atmosphere, 2. For its inclination, and 3. For its core. 1. As we can see, the atmospheres of both planets are entirely different. And the main difference is that Neptune is much more active, while Uranus is very quiet and almost without storm clouds. 2. The 97-degree tilt of Uranus causes extreme weather on its surface, causing one of its hemispheres to point to the sun for 42 uninterrupted years, while the other hemisphere remains in total darkness for 42 years. This causes its temperature to drop and be even colder. In contrast, Neptune has a relatively normal inclination, so it does not undergo the same abrupt changes in temperature that Uranus suffers. 3. And finally, perhaps the most crucial reason Uranus is colder than Neptune is that the latter has an internal heat source in the core while Uranus does not. The reasons why Uranus lost this heat source are still up for debate, but so far the most accepted theory is that in the past, billions of years ago, a vast body collided with Uranus. This impact on a planetary scale caused the tilt axis of Uranus to remain as it is today and also made the heat of its core dissipate faster, cooling the planet quickly. It is likely that if Uranus had a hot core like Neptune, it would also have a higher temperature, and in that case, the coldest planet would be Neptune and not Uranus. For now, we don't know, but perhaps in the future with new research and spacecraft that visit this planet, we will be able to discover all the mysteries about these two planets that have more in common than it seems. Today, it is thought that most exoplanets in the galaxy are very similar to Uranus. Do you think we should make an effort to investigate this planet more? Let us know your opinion in the comments.